you know, as well as being able to play the bass.
I suppose that our last label was, as far as what went on in America and the rest of Europe, it became quite, you know, you knew what was going to happen. It wasn't a good situation with the rest of the world, as it were, and we were getting really fed up with being put on long tours for kind of no reason, really.
Definitely, I think there was an element towards the end of the last record where we were kind of so dissatisfied with the way that things were kind of going, and the fact that we were, you know, being sort of committed to doing things that were really kind of pointless, you know, and that we didn't all necessarily want to be doing at that time. And there definitely was an element of, like, we needed a break, you know, and we took this time off and did our other things that we wanted to do, and came back fresh with a sort of attitude that we were going to do this at our own pace.
We all enjoy writing songs together, and that's why we're still playing in the band together, really. I think it's really not any more complicated than that.
There's always been different ways of doing things, you know, whether it be writing songs, a couple of us acoustically, and working on those ideas, or whether it be kind of working on musical ideas as a group, and then Roddy kind of fitting around that, or whether it be just all of us in a room coming up with ideas together, which is much more what this record's been like, I think, especially because we've been off doing other things on our own, and then just coming back into an environment with a new band and everybody being involved, and just kind of enjoying playing together again, and songs kind of just came really quickly that way. It's been much more of a collaborative sort of group effort this time than it ever has been.
This record, we really wanted to just play it loud, you know, yeah. Like this room's where we wrote all the songs, and we recorded them here too. And I suppose it was, again, it's kind of a cliche, isn't it, getting back to the way, because that's how we first wrote songs when we first started the group, and that's how we wrote the songs for this record.
It was just, let's write 12 songs and record them and see what kind of record it is. And that was very much the approach that we had this time. It was just like, everybody kind of get together and play, and let's see what this new band with a new dynamic, what kind of music comes out, and that was what came out. It's a frustrating process, definitely, when you're on a major label and you have to kind of listen to people's opinions that you don't really want to listen to all the time. And not having that around, having the freedom to do what we wanted to do, was a big sort of positive change for us.
So something still compelling to me about walking into a space like this and, you know, 2 hours later leaving it when you've made a song.
In a way, I try not to get jealous about the guys being in LA for 9 weeks recording the last record, you know, Rosyth has its charms.
It is the same people, and we did record the whole record in our practice space with Dave Eringa, who's done a lot of records with us in the past, and we have a real relationship with, almost without wishing to sound cheesy, he is kind of like a member of the band in a way that he understands how we play together and our strengths and our weaknesses. And we did it in 2 weeks, recorded it in here in 2 weeks.
Certainly, I think, because the last record was so kind of confused between rock music and folk music, I think doing this record, folk record with Roddy, and me doing another record myself with someone else, it's kind of allowed us to get a lot of the kind of folk influence stuff out of it, not out of our system, but we've kind of done that in other ways, and with this band all we really wanted to do then was make a rock record.
It's like forming a band again, that same sort of feeling, but obviously being 10 years old, I was 19 when I formed the band and I'm 30, so it's quite, you know, I'm a different person, but it does feel the same way, sort of, when you don't have to impress anyone else but yourself. We'll be right back.
when we were playing loud, fast rock music, everybody was listening to acoustic music, and then our software record came out and it was all... We've just never been in step with kind of the popular, you know, what's going on in guitar music, I suppose. Which is probably why we're still making, you know, our fifth record.
You could break me by the bones until you break me inside. You could drag me from my home.
So yeah, with Make Another World, we just kind of went back to the way we actually were to begin with. Like I said, just writing songs in a practice space and not dwelling too much on bridges or verses, just kind of getting on with it. And I think that's why the record sounds the way it does. And If It Takes You Home, which is like a limited edition 7-inch they're putting out, is just a sort of a brash reminder of, I suppose, what the band, you know, used to sound like. Song like that, I mean, I'm not ashamed to admit, I just stand back and it's the riff's the most important thing in a rock song, not the words really. I suppose the main difference between If It Takes You Home and No Emotion is there's a much uses, it's almost got a disco beat, which is quite rare for us.
It's also quite sparse in the guitars as well, there's not like layers and layers of guitars, like, you know, so If It Takes You Home, there's a lot of guitars in there to give it that.
We've always kind of treated every song on its own merits and the way that it wants to be recorded. It's not so much about, you know, one being more important than the other. It's just one song seems to suit, you know, a fairly raw kind of simple approach, and one suits a more sort of produced kind of image, I guess.
Personally speaking, I think we've always been first and foremost a live band, you know what I mean? That's how we started.
Yeah, a band's only really a band if it's playing, and that means, like, other than that, it's just like a kind of an idea between a group of people. So I think it's really important to go on tour, but we've had done so much touring in the past and been on those kind of slog tours that get you nowhere,
yeah,
that none of us will ever do that again. There are some bands people just want to be around all the time, like the Rolling Stones. They're never going to go away, really.
Yeah, I suppose.
If you're not a massive, if you're not a massive band, you don't want
to,
you know, like Nice and Sleazy's in 43rd birthday. No, it's just so grim. You know? But I think, yeah, there's still enough spirit in the group at the moment to carry on doing that for a while. And I think this is the right time to make a record like this. If we'd waited and done it in 5 years' time, I don't think we'd have been able to do it with as much conviction, because. I mean, I'm interested in lots of different kinds of music, and so is Alan, but we made a conscious decision, Idlewild and this record, to make a strong, loud rock record.
Yeah.
But I think in future we won't want to do that again, so we'll do something different. So it was the right time to make it, and I think it sounds all the better for it.
So much more important to us at this stage in our life, I think, you know, having done this for 11 years now, and to be able to be finally in control of what we're doing again is just so important to us, you know.